in my life. I seen it all, and now it's time for me to pass on this knowledge to you, all my sisters, my troubled sisters. This is my gift to you.
Been many days, couldn't take the pain that I should take my life away. See it every day in every other young sister's face. See, I'm crying now, my fill of doubt. Running in the streets, low self-esteem, thinking that used to be me. What a shame.
Damn, life as a mother, it's hard to sit back and see the same thing happened to you.
This ain't love, but here's the love. I wanna get it
good. Doesn't matter what they say or do, don't let it get to you. You'll be afraid. You can break through. Take what I've been through to see that you can't hold a good woman down.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. You're listening to another live show of He Say, She Say, and I'm King Gerald Jones. Today we have the privilege of being here with three beautiful women. I'm going to let the beautiful women introduce themselves, but first, I want to let you know this is the Lioness Den. What we like to do is encourage dialogue between women. Primarily, this is when we focus on the women's opinion or the women's perspective, and we like to get their views and beliefs in things, on things. Of course, we have He Say, She Say with me and the beautiful Shawn Jones, but again, this is the Lioness Den. So they're going to introduce themselves, and they're going to, I guess, say what do they bring to the Lioness Den, and then we're going to get right into it.
Hi, everybody.
Wait.
What?
Sorry to interrupt.
What?
We have to give out the number because I know we already had callers, so we're going to have callers because there's a lot of women that might have questions or, you know, different opinions or perspectives than the three women we have here. So we're going to give out the number. You could call in. I know you guys want to call in on me too because y'all hate me, but we're going to take y'all calls. The number is 323-965-1600. Again, the number is 323-965-1600, and I'm going to go ahead and let the beautiful ladies introduce themselves.
Hi, everybody. I am the She and She Say. I'm old news. You guys don't really want to hear from me. I have two beautiful ladies next to me who are hanging out with us tonight, and I'm really interested in getting their perspective. I'm Shawn Jones, the other Jones to the He Say, She Say.
No relationship.
But I'm going to pass it to the beautiful woman sitting next to me.
I'm Siobhan, also known as @ShayBlack, and today, what I hope to bring is not only my honesty, but a little bit of clarity. Because it seems like some people might need a little bit of that, male and female.
And hi, good evening, everyone. My name is April Showers, and I look forward to bringing forth open-mindedness, mm-hmm. honesty, with reservation. Because everyone wants to be wild, but still be declared a woman.
I love that. That I love.
Absolutely.
That I love. This is going to be fun.
It is.
You know, this is my first time being on this side of the microphone with just the lionesses.
So we should... We should enjoy this thing.
Wait a minute. Nicki Minaj says just cupcaking or, you know.
Leave it to him to take it out of context.
Well, I want to get right into it. But before we ask the questions or, you know, start discussing things, I want to play a video for you guys. This video I found on Facebook, and it really spoke to me. Mm-hmm. And it was a lot of difference of opinions from women. Men, but more so women. Some women, I guess, agree with it, and some women didn't. So I want to play it for you ladies, and afterwards I want to ask you, do you agree with it, and I guess give your feelings on it after we see the video.
Okay.
So we're going to play the video.
I have heard many women who want to be in a relationship attempt to rationalize why they are still single by using the tired cliche, it's gonna take a strong man to handle a strong woman like me. Anyone with a slight bit of discernment knows that this really translates as, it takes a strong man to handle my lack of femininity, to handle my overbearing personality, to handle my need to be in control, and to handle my incessant disrespect. Problems should be handled Children should be handled. Animals should be handled. Chemicals should be handled. But a grown adult woman should not need to be handled by anyone. When a man is faced with handling a woman, one out of three things usually happens. One, she is handled. Manhandled. Two, she remains single and yet continues to beat her chest about how strong she is. Or three, she gets a man, but this man is a passive mangina simp who is willing to lay down his masculinity in order for her to come and pick it back up. See, what these strong personality personas don't understand is that strong men usually gravitate towards women whose strength is not rooted in obnoxiousness, nor is it derived from her ability to take on male characteristics. This woman knows how to influence without aggression. This woman is in touch with her emotions, but she's not overwhelmed by them. This woman is not delusional to the fact that she's naturally vulnerable, and she realizes that it would actually make her weak for her to resist her vulnerability by trying to be overly self-sufficient. This woman does not equate strength with merely playing a role in a broken home. She understands that if a man is too consumed with trying to handle her, there won't be room for him to actually love and adore her. This woman is strong because she is secure in her femininity, and she embraces the Most High's purpose for her life. She is fearless when her man leads or takes control. She knows she's female and that her true strength lies in her womanhood and not pseudo manhood. That being said, if any woman feels that she needs to be handled, she should not be seeking a relationship. She should be seeking help for an identity crisis.
Well, I got a strong personality. It takes a special guy to deal with me. I already know that. No, I mean, I cook, I clean, I take care of home and everything, but I have a strong personality, and guys seem to think I'm too much like a guy. I see a lot of men are men, they're little boys, and they can't deal with my personality because I'm too much of a, hey, I say I got balls too, mine's just at the top.
Gotcha.
You know what I'm saying? But at the end of the day, if I'm too more man than you, that's a problem.
So women. I know you saw the video.
Mm-hmm.
First and foremost, is there anyone that disagrees with what she's saying?
I don't.
Or any points? Any points? Or was everything on? Oh, April.
I kind of do object to some of the things that she's saying but it also depends on the type of woman that she's like really talking about. Because for me, I think I probably fall along her category that she's saying as far as, you know, you're so strong,
right,
this guy can't handle you, so on and so forth. And I don't really think, and it's like presenting as if I'm like trying to put out some form of masculinity,
right,
and that's really not the case.
Right.
The case is I understand who I am.
Uh-huh.
I know the type that I want, and there's nothing wrong with a woman that, because at the end of the day, we are women. We go from girls to, teenagers to women.
Right.
And so with that being said, we go through different phases in life, and all depending on how that main man, like really being your father, like really treated you, accepted you, and coddled you, is what you really expect out of a man to, you know what I'm saying, provide you all those things. And there's nothing wrong with that. He's supposed to be able to support you, whether you're strong, whether you're vulnerable, whether you're weak, whether you're anything.
Right.
So there's nothing wrong with a strong woman wanting a man to be all those things,
right,
for her.
So with that being said, do you think that you need to be handled? Do you think it takes a guy to, quote-unquote, handle you?
No, not necessarily
handle.
Do you
think you
need to
be handled?
Really, for me, I would, like, define it as merging into my lane.
Okay.
Not necessarily handling me, because a person can know how to talk to you, how to treat you, how to, like, navigate you to, you know what I'm saying, where you need, you know, to, I don't know, I guess to where you're able to communicate with the person,
right,
to where you're not really being, but that is a form of handling. You
right.
know how to handle with care.
Right,
you
right.
know, it's all depend on how a person wants to use the word.
Got you. So any other lady, do y'all disagree or y'all agree, or do y'all want to add to what she said or give clarity in your opinion?
I agree with it. And to kind of touch on that a little bit, not every woman has that coddling from their father or from that male figure. So
right.
Sometimes some of the things can be, you know, taken a little bit differently.
Mm-hmm.
So mm-hmm. if you don't have that to learn by, or, you know, you don't have that structure, mm-hmm. you know, it ends up being a little bit different.
Right. And they're probably a little bit more harsher, like, so I definitely understand.
Mm. Sean?
For me, it honestly depends on what I want from the man and what kind of man it is.
Oh, okay.
Like, in general, overall, uh-huh. I completely agree with what she's saying.
Right.
And when I'm thinking about a relationship, fully.
Right, right, right.
Fully agree, fully commit to
but
what she's saying.
But not if it's just someone you're dating?
When we talk about someone I'm dating, if it's someone I'm dating for the future, uh-huh. that's completely different than someone I'm dating for the now.
Okay.
So if it's someone I'm dating for the now, then no, you don't get that. There's a level of submission with that.
Right, and I was going to get into that. But I want to ask you that before. Do women date for the now?
I do.
Because it's always, do you date for the now, April? And do you date for the now, Savon?
I mix it, yes.
And when I say date,
exactly.
And when I say date for the now, I mean it's no emotional ties. You know, it's just fun. You may enjoy this.
For me personally, it depends on where I am in my life. Like, I'm a woman that I unfortunately, / fortunately, uh-huh. wasn't the little girl that grew up with the dream of the, what we talked about, this,
right,
with the
right.
white picket fence and the 2.5 children and the dog. Like,
right.
that's not my thing.
Right.
So my dating, my expectations from dating, my level of submission with dating, and my desires for dating are based on where I am in my life,
right,
and
gotcha.
What I want at that particular point in time.
Agree. I have to agree with that.
So when I'm at a point where I want to be in a relationship,
that's
then I date a
for.
Certain type of man,
right. gotcha.
And I give myself to a certain degree,
right.
which is kind of where I am now. Okay. I want a relationship.
Ooh.
I know, right?
Ooh. Yeah.
There's Ooh. Levels to it.
So right. I'm dating a certain type of man, uh-huh. and I'm giving myself to a certain degree.
Okay.
When I'm just hanging out, it's like I'm not in a place where I want to be submissive when I have other stuff going on. When I know that I can't fully give myself to someone, then I date differently.
Gotcha.
And so what I give is completely different, and the type of man I date is completely different as well.
Gotcha. Mm-hmm. Gotcha. With that being said, I want each and every one to tell me, what's your idea or ideology of submission? Will you submit? Let me get to that first. Will you submit to a man? And what is your thought process or definition of submission?
Okay, I'll start. I definitely know that I can submit to a man.
Uh-huh.
My definition of the guy that I would submit myself to is that person that really, like I said, just handles me on all accords.
Right. Do you feel, because I just had this, I guess, a discussion with a young lady, mm-hmm. and she said that she think or that a man and a woman supposed to submit to each other. Is that a possible thought process of you, or do you think it's all submission from the woman going towards the man?
I think male and female do submit to each other in different entities. However, in a relationship, there's always that dominant submissive.
Right, right, right.
You know what I'm saying? So, no, you definitely can, like, both parties do. But I think they do it on different levels. Mm-hmm. Like, one may do it on cooking. One may do it on errands. One may do it. But then at the end of the day, there's always a dominant force in a relationship that has their plateau.
Quick question. Can you be the dominant son?
I can be. I don't want to be. But let me tell you this.
Bam.
I am.
Holla. Right there. That part.
When I'm dating just to date.
You dominant.
I am the dominant.
Oh, no. And how do you interact with a man that's, I guess, the opposite of dominant, which is submissive?
We going to do what I want to do.
Or not at all.
Exactly. Or not at all.
Like, right. Who does that?
Right. But when I'm in a place to not be in a relationship, or when I'm not looking for anything serious, then that is where I am. Like, either it's on my terms or it's none at all.
Yeah. Okay. And most of the time, they're dealing with you because they really want to deal on your terms.
Right.
If they complain,
can you
that's
handle?
Because they're not really used. They really want you to dominate them. Like, that's when that becomes the dominant submissive.
And
that's
in reverse role.
And that's why there are different types of men.
Mm-hmm.
Like, for me to be in a relationship, for me to want to be with someone, he has to be he has to be dominant.
Right.
He has to want to be dominant, and I have to trust him to be dominant. And that's the thing for me, because I make pretty decent decisions, and I've created a pretty decent platform.
Right. So how are you going to come to my life and not make good? Right. And I totally respect that. I understand. I think a lot of men lose sight of that. I think they think they're just supposed to be reverenced and submitted to
dashiki'd.
Right.
We're not doing that.
Right. Like where do they we're in America.
And that's the thing that I think a lot of men don't understand, especially when dealing with me. I come with stuff because I'm me and I'm human.
Right.
So I come with stuff. But I don't come with a lot of stuff that other women my age with.
Right.
I don't have a baby daddy.
Right.
I don't have kids that are coming into the equation.
Right.
Like, I don't have a lot of stuff that most women my age have coming into the equation.
Gotcha.
So because I don't have that, certain stuff I'm not dealing with.
Oh, okay, gotcha.
Because I'm not bringing it to you.
Right.
And so if I'm not bringing that kind of drama to you.
I think it has to do with the baggage part. I think that everyone in general is basically going to say what their terms of what they will deal with and what they won't deal with, period. I mean,
I think a lot of men, and this is just my experience, and because I'm not a mother.
Right.
Most men my age come with children.
Gotcha.
And they come with mothers of children.
Right.
And even if they don't have the drama, they still have stipulations on what they can and cannot do. And I'm not going to be with a man that's not a great dad. So even though I can date a man that doesn't have baby mama drama, we can't pack up and go to Vegas this weekend because he has Saturdays with his daughter.
Right.
We can't pack up and fly to Tahiti for a week because he has parent-teacher conferences.
And are you willing to accept those things, dating a man that has children? Or you wouldn't.
No. If he's the kind of man that I want to be in a relationship with, then yes.
Oh, okay.
If he's just the kind of man I want to hang
out
with.
Not even going to waste
like,
your time.
You're going to do your thing. No, and
I'm
there's
not doing
nothing
that.
Wrong with that.
So, Siobhan, back to the original question or topic. Submission. First of all, do you think you can be a dominant, or have you been a dominant before?
Yes.
And how did that fare? Did it go good or how?
It didn't work out.
So
it didn't work out. Okay. I mean, dominant is not what I want to be. I believe that as I've grown older, I've learned the place or the role of a woman and being submissive.
Right.
Submission is very important to me at this time in my life because I have been that single mom. I do bring the children. I do bring the other types of baggage. However, I've done this for quite a while.
Mm-hmm.
And to continue doing it, do I want to? No.
Mm-hmm.
I'm ready to give that right. Mm-hmm. I don't want to have to handle everything. Right. I want to be vulnerable. I want to know that someone is going to make great decisions for all of us.
So what is your idea of a dominant man?
A man that I trust making decisions on my behalf, because there again, I feel like I have a good decision-making ability.
Right.
And if I'm not going to let go or be 100% submissive to someone who does not have good decision-making qualities.
Right.
Period.
But that's the best feeling in the world. Like for me personally,
to let go.
It is the best feeling for me personally.
So how long? Well, and not to cut you off, but and this is amazing me over here. How do you learn that? Okay, because no one's perfect.
No.
So with that being said, I'm sure you're going to see flaws or missed decisions that he makes. How do you let yourself go, possibly seeing three mistakes that he's made that you know that you wouldn't have made for yourself? So how do you let go and submit with that?
One, it has to be someone who I can learn from.
Mm-hmm.
And for me, that's the biggest thing. I can't be with a man I can't learn from.
Right.
And I'm relatively intelligent.
Right.
So if I'm in awe of you, and if I'm in awe of your knowledge, and if I'm in awe of the way that you think and the way that you look at the world,
kind of under your power,
then I'm good.
Right, gotcha.
But that's rare for me.
Mm.
But when it happens, dude, I'm all in.
Right.
And it's a beautiful thing for me to be able to let go, because I am so rigid when it comes to certain things, and I am so I think things through, and I'm not callous with my decision making, hence the fact that I don't have a lot of stuff going on. Like, I'm very rigid with my decision making. So when I'm with a guy, or when I meet a guy, or when I can entrust myself to a man who can teach me, dude, you got it.
Right. And with that being said, that deep, receive it, respect it, and understand it. But I also want to make sure we get on the point of, but if you saw him not make some not so good decisions, not always, of course, you're going to, but let's say once or twice.
It depends on what kind of decisions.
Okay.
It honestly depends on what kind of decisions, because I've been with a man who didn't make decisions exactly like I would.
Right.
But it was okay. It's like, I still trust you. Okay. But when, this is the thing,
reckless
when you make decisions,
reckless decisions,
when you make decisions like, I have $50 and I'm either going to pay the light bill or we're going to go to dinner, and you decide to go to dinner versus paying the light bill, I can't entrust myself.
But
that's what happens a lot of the time.
Right.
And that's not me. That's not how I live. That's not how I choose to make my decisions.
I wouldn't want
so ultimately, that's not the type of man you would.
Nope.
Right.
So it's that kind of thing.
Right.
No, but even with her saying that, like, the man that's looking at you as that that love interest or whatever, would he want you to be making reckless decisions? Like she said, would you want a woman that's going to pay the bills or go out there and buy a bag?
Right.
You know what I'm saying? At the end of the day, how can that man even entrust and build in you? You know what I'm saying? Knowing that you're, like, frivolous like that. So I definitely understand.
Right. And not like making the right decisions for anything. Right. I mean, like, for himself as well. It's
right.
Like, if he can't even make a good decision for himself, how are you even capable of making a decision
and
for someone
for
else?
Both I've of dated us. Guys like that.
Yes.
And like, cool guys. And they, it's like, okay, well, I have $100 in my pocket, so let's go to dinner. Let's go do this. Let's go do that. And then 3 days later, I can't entrust myself to you because that's not how I want to live my life.
Gotcha.
Right. And that's pretty much how I make the decisions. Like, is your decision-making process one in which I entrust you with me to live my life?
Right.
But there again, it's always going to take a big lot of time. And
to learn it.
Does
it take a lot of time for you to see it, Shawn?
Usually, no.
Okay. Yeah, I was going to say where
it comes out pretty quickly, and I say that a whole lot. I feel like in the beginning of relationships, what one of the biggest problems is the love blinders. People are so infatuated with the actual being in a relationship that they don't notice very key things that are very noticeable had they not had their blinders on.
You know, and I call it like compromising of deal breakers. Like, there are things in life that we just really are opposed of.
Mm-hmm.
And because of what you just said, the fact that I want to be in a relationship, now you're
they'll
going against your deal,
it, right.
The deal breaker. Like, you wouldn't deal with this from anyone. So, but
that.
Because of you thirsting for a relationship, and maybe you see something in this cute little person that you don't want the next little chick to have.
Mm-hmm.
But that deal breaker is costing you heartache and pain.
At this time in life, there is no such thing as what that chick has, because that chick is not me, nor will she ever be, nor will she hold the qualities that I hold.
Right. Which goes
she's
into
not even
a lot
a factor.
Deeper than
right.
what we're talking about. And it's right.
Now, one of the things for me, you have to almost drag me. You have to almost drug me and drag me to be in a relationship.
Drug and drag. At the same time.
Like, seriously, you have to almost drug and drag me to be in a relationship.
Right.
So for me personally, where it's a trip because I hear so many women say they can't find a good guy or a guy that wants to be in a relationship.
Right.
I find guys that want to be in a relationship
right,
with me
right,
and
right.
I'm like,
right.
That's
so crazy.
But
to cut you off, but do you notice that maybe, I don't want to call them weaker because we don't know them, but the guys that want to be in a relationship, the ones that want to be in a relationship, do you think they're a different caliber?
Some yes and some no.
Okay.
And when I say some yes and some no, there are two categories for me,
okay.
from my experience.
Okay.
One is the weaker guy,
uh-huh.
the guy that I can dominate, the guy that I can run over, the guy that I do not trust to make decisions for me.
Right.
And then on the other hand, it's the guy who has attained certain things,
uh-huh.
and they're like, okay, look, I need to go ahead and settle down. Like, I own my own business. I have this
okay.
one. I have this going.
So he's ready for
so
it.
So it's like, I don't want to keep messing with these chicks who could potentially mess up what I'm building. I'd rather have someone I know that I can trust to help me grow what it is that I've already attained. So it's two different kinds of guys.
But then what ends up happening, to piggyback off of what you're saying, that same particular guy, because he has dealt with all those particular chicks, will now come into the company of that chick that he wants. And guess what? You're so jaded by these other chicks that you don't even know how to treat the chick that you want.
In some cases, that is so true.
So guess what? Who ends up losing? Not on, if you lose, but the person who really is the one that's worth it, like the one that you're chasing, that person ends up losing like the greatest because really they cut. Well, not, no, I say that if you're like a good catch, like you allow your circumstances to really like mess up a good thing that's in front of you.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? That's like the past haunting you for the present.
And you're right. And I've seen that on both hands. One, and you know some of my friends.
Right.
Like, if you're successful but you don't know the person and you haven't had like a real basic relationship with the person, then you are very leery of what they want from you. But if you've known the person before you even had anything and they loved you then,
but then that's the thing. They can still be carrying more time to get to know the person. You have to get to know the person. I mean,
on
like,
on an intimate level, like on the
regardless
like,
of if you know them or not. Okay, you shouldn't even be thinking relationship until you know them.
Correct. And
you
that's
have to
what
have
ends
some
up
type of friendship, some type of something before you can even start discussing relationship.
Because it has to go back to friends first.
Okay. Well, I want to tie into something that is still, and the funny part, the premise of today's show is kind of like submission and. So I want to tie into something that I also discussed on my Facebook, completion.
Mm-hmm.
Completion. Mm-hmm. Of course, I want to ask each, I'm going to start with Savannah in the middle.
What?
I kind of don't, but I am.
No, let's start with her because she goes like either way. I have no idea what she's going to say.
I want to know, do you feel that a man completes you? And explain how and why, but don't forget to also add, do you think you complete a man as a woman?
I've been thinking about this one all day from the
Jeopardy
drum
beat. Drum roll, please.
I do believe that a man completes a woman because there are so many features that women don't hold alone. And in order to have that perfect balance, it's like you can't reproduce by yourself. You can protect yourself within reason. You can't really make yourself feel 100% safe. There's so many different components to it that, yes, I do.
Okay.
And
do you feel that a woman completes a man?
I don't know. I have to think about that. I don't know if I really.
Please don't get it confused with need or want. I want the actual complete. And I'm gonna give you. Well, I'm gonna give you the physical, and this is just my opinion from my research. I'm gonna give you the physical research that I've. A woman, of course, has a void or a vagina or an opening, which is meant to be filled. You guys, women, y'all listening? Y'all listening?
Of course,
okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Well,
it's meant to be filled. It's meant to be filled by a penis.
Duh.
Right.
By a penis. So that in the physical realm, not speaking emotional, not speaking mental, not speaking anything else but the physical. In the physical realm, that shows me or teaches me that a woman is completed by a man. Because without that, and that's kind of like preludes to her emotions. Not saying it's all emotion, which
but
you
have
said. Okay, so with that being said.
Then I would say
Hold on. Let me ask April. So with that being said, what example or what physical feature or what physical part of the anatomy do a woman complete a man?
So we can use the example of 50 Shades of Grey.
Right.
That man was a billionaire, although he was born into it. But still, money was like not an issue for him. He was even successful in business.
Right.
And guess what? At the end of the day, I don't really care like about like the yearn, the want, the flesh. Da, da, da. At the end of the day, like you need a woman to
remember I said not need complete.
Okay.
Because I will be the first to admit, and make sure you put the camera on me, I'll be the first to admit and let it be known that I need a woman, men need women, of course. But I want to kind of get down to the
So with that being said, if you watch the movie and all and how you interpreted it, she was more than just flesh for him.
Right. Well, that's what I meant. Well, that, well, and I'm not
and
saying.
It's
and
more
I'm not
so
saying.
With that being said, it becomes greater and deeper than.
And I'm not saying. And I'm not saying you're wrong at all. Uh-huh. I just recognize that being on the physical level. Let's, I mean, excuse me, the mental level. Let's say on the mental level, you're right. That she completed him, however.
And she completed him emotionally. Because guess what? She made him feel things that he wouldn't felt with anybody
and
else.
And guess what? I also agree with you on that.
Humanize him.
I just want to specify, and can I get this? I'm and again, to put my white flag up, I'm searching for an answer from you women. Because from my research, I saw, I complete a woman when I'm going in her, when I'm inside of her, and then I create a life through her.
No, but a woman can empower you. Because guess what? Men, you guys have these egos. You guys go through head trips. We don't know when you're feeling vulnerable or whatnot. And all depending on how that woman is connected with you, can she build you, empower you, make you go, and, like, forget everybody that's around you. So, yes, she is pertinent to you. Yes, she... She is what she is.
Again.
On the whole.
I agree with April.
I don't think that there's like that 100% need for a man to have all of that because he has natural strength. He has natural intelligence. He has, you know, things that were genetically built within him.
A little girl is broken, a little boy is broken, and all depending on what is really like invested into that man does that. That's how that woman is really important and necessary for him. You know what I'm saying? As far as teaching and building.
Go ahead. The definition of completion is fulfillment.
Right.
So ultimately, we can break it down. You can talk about the physical aspect. You can talk about the mental aspect. You can talk about the emotional aspect. But the definition of completion is fulfillment.
Right.
And unless you're a homosexual man,
you can't be filled.
You cannot be fulfilled without certain aspects of a woman.
And guess what?
And I'm not even talking about vagina. I'm not even talking about sex.
Right.
I'm just speaking generally.
Right.
We were not made to be independent of one another.
Right.
So can I? Am I complete without a man? No.
Right.
I am not.
Right.
And I am. It doesn't matter. I can pay my bills.
Right.
I've gone to school.
Right.
I own my own stuff.
Right.
All of that is great.
Right.
I can dress myself. I can feed myself.
Right.
But the bottom line is, I am not my best self
without
a great man.
Correct.
Totally agree. Now, this is what I want you guys to do, because you guys, all of you basically agree with that and voice that. I kind of want y'all to be devil's advocate or answer a question for me and the men, because that's ultimately what we're here for, is to get answers. Have you came across women that feels differently than what you guys said?
Absolutely.
And can you give us an idea of why they may feel that way?
To be honest with you, with the women that I interact with, I'm the minority. But I'm a woman who looks to submit to a man.
Right.
Now, don't get me wrong. I'm not going to just do it to anybody. And I'm perfectly okay in my space,
if
in my world,
by
myself.
Right.
But I'm not my best self by myself.
I agree with that.
Right. The women that I come across that I run into are women who they have education, they own their own stuff, they have good jobs,
do you think the physical things or those attributes or them accomplishments make them push away?
I think what they've... Two things. What we're taught, and it's one of the things, I was kind of given a balance.
Mm-hmm.
We're taught, or girls are taught, you know, you go to school, you get a good job, or you do what you need to do, you take care of yourself. You don't depend on no man. You do what you need to do to be able to take care of yourself.
Right.
For me personally, I grew up in a home where my dad never cooked a meal.
Mm.
My grandfather pretty much didn't cook a meal until my grandmother got old and, you know, couldn't see, and then he had to take to the stove.
Right.
So I grew up in a world where the men provided for the women, they provided for the families, and the women took care of the families.
Right.
So in turn, I can take care of me, but that's not necessarily what I desire to do.
Right.
I have a desire to take care of a man.
Okay.
But I also have a desire to be taken care of.
Right.
Now, on the other hand, a lot of the women that I know that are professionals who have good jobs, making good money, and who own their own stuff, and who can do whatever they want to do and go wherever they want to go, when they meet men, and I meet the same kind of men,
right,
who you don't really bring anything to the table. All you bring to the table is penis.
Right.
Like, that's cool. They sell that in the store.
Right.
So, real talk.
No, seriously.
And I'm being serious. Like, right. if you're talking about, and I'm going to be real blunt with this, if you're talking about an orgasm, I can do that on my own, right, by myself, right, in my own house with nobody else there.
But they do get lonely, Janet Jackson.
I don't get lonely.
But you're not a fun, and I totally get that, and I respect that anybody with any kind of sense would. But my thing
some
is...
Some men only want to bring penis to the table.
But what about the men? What about the men that bring? Because I've seen it where the men can bring to the table, and I guess because the women have accomplished so much alone that...
The independent women.
But what are you bringing, though? And that's what are you bringing? Like, I'm a woman who looks to submit.
Okay.
But even me, when I meet guys, you coming to me, and it's like, what you bringing a headache.
Right.
Why do I want that?
Right, right, right.
You're bringing more femininity to the relationship than I'm bringing.
Right, right, right.
Why do I want that? I get that.
There's really too much femininity.
No, like, there are men who want to be treated like females.
Right.
And I really don't get... Well, I get it because of, like, the, like, destruction within the relationships of, relationships,
right.
But if you really do want a strong woman ain't gonna treat you like her kid.
Right. Right. I want to ask you.
You know what I'm saying? So why would I want to not be jacking off and cussing you out?
Right, right.
I'm just saying.
I want to ask you guys a question, and it's going to get a little vulgar, because I was, again, and a lot of my feedback or things come from Instagram and Facebook. I actually made a post about what we're talking about. And I had a woman, and I want y'all to correct me if I'm wrong, or
you
give me some kind of perspective or something. She said, and I want to quote verbatim, but I'm not going to go through the phone.
No, do it verbatim.
But for the most part, she said, every man has bits in him.
Oh.
Do you guys agree?
Okay,
that's a good time. I want to hear.
If there is a man that has a certain degree of bitch in him, he is not a man. That is a male.
No, then that's true.
That is a bitch ass nigga. I cannot.
So do you
not tolerate?
I don't agree with that.
I won't agree with that.
I don't, because I've had some men that I love, and they had no. It was like you. It's got hot in here.
But
let me tell you this.
What?
From my experience, and I'm only speaking from my experience, if I lined up 10 men, three might have no bitch in them, and seven have bitch in them.
And guess what's the funny part about that is I can respect that statistic, even if you said eight.
Mm-hmm.
But this woman,
everyone.
And I have to, like, really have to understand
I don't agree with that.
Maybe she was thinking that, like, all the guys that in that category were, like, raised by, like, that type of woman.
Maybe that's what she attracts.
That part.
In reality, like, to be honest with you, of thinking in my mind right now, I'm going through 10 men.
Right.
I can really honestly say three.
Thank you.
Had no bitch in them.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, I'll take the title for one of them. But the rest of them?
Right. They did.
And I can respect that. April?
I was just going to say, so coming from the psychosis of the woman who is diagnosing these men as that.
Right.
What she's saying is, you was raised by that type of woman.
Uh-huh.
You know what I'm saying?
No, that's all I date is that type of man.
That's what she said.
That was my thing, and I even said it on my Facebook, like, I feel bad for you. Your father, your brothers, your cousins, your uncles, any man you laid up with, any man who dick you sucked, any man.
And I didn't even add my daddy to my rationale. I just added it to the man I date. My daddy don't have no bitch in him.
So you've been fucking with bitch ass niggas.
But that's the thing that I think a lot of people don't take to, they don't recognize, they don't internalize. You attract certain things because of who you are.
Right, right.
You, if you're a woman and all you've ever dated are no good ass niggas,
you might have to question your shit.
You need to
start looking in the mirror. Some people might get mad at me, but
it is what it is. I've never had a relationship with a no good ass nigga.
Right, right, right.
Because when I see it, You gotta go.
It's funny because one of the girls commented said that. April, what were you saying about?
What about the girl that's like really dirty, no good, but she gets all those good guys and she's polluting them with her mistreatment, and now
because that guy needs to turn around and look at what type of energy is he putting in the air to keep attracting these type women?
Well, my thing is for because
I don't care what role it is, male or female.
This guy is looking for real true love and affection or whatever from this woman. You know what I'm saying? That's kind of like mistreatment. You fall for people. It is what it is. Love is what it is. But what do you say for that person?
I have male friends like that. I have male friends that are great guys.
Right.
Great guys. But this is the thing, though. The kind of women that they're attracted to aren't attracted to them. And so, because they are who they are, and they're attracted to, I was talking to one of my friends. I kid you not. Today, I'm like, you want the model type. You want the Instagram model type. You want the girl who's getting 100. Getting 1,000 likes and rolling around in this and having guys do this. She's not gonna take you seriously, because she has access to all this other stuff.
Right.
But this is who you want to be with.
Right.
You have to. It's the same thing for men as it is for women. In my mind, in my opinion, in my practice, in my experience, and I'm not all knowing, but just from what I see, it's the same thing with men. Men have a type too. Just like women are like the bad boy, they want the rough dude, they want the bad boy, and then he treats them bad and jacks them up and runs over them. Guys want a certain, because some guys, not all, they want a certain kind of woman too. You want the model type. Well, but what do you think she's going
to
be used
to? But you don't think he wants to be submissive to this girl, going back to what the whole thing is about, like, submissive and domination. Like,
I don't want to
maybe because he's dominant in this professional part of his world, like, in the love part, yeah, I don't want to, like, be beating my chest. I want to just, like, really give my all to that woman, also forever my lady type thing.
It happens. I definitely believe it happens. But I think sometimes, just like women, they choose the wrong men to give themselves to. The men choose the wrong women to give themselves to. Right. I don't think it's any different. I really don't. I don't think it's any different. And we like to disseminate sexes and act like men don't have some of the same desires that women have.
Yeah, because
we all want to be loved. Mm-hmm. We all want to be taken care of. Mm-hmm. We all want to have somebody that we can go home to, rely on, depend on, and fall into at the end of the day.
Correct.
Even the strongest person,
correct,
they may tell themselves they don't,
right,
but ultimately we all have innate human needs,
correct, and
period.
That person who sparks the desire, we can't help it.
So I think with a lot of those men, a lot of the time, and I'm just guessing because I don't know who you're talking about.
I'm just saying it's
physical. It's like she looks a certain way, she dresses a certain way, her hair is a certain way, her complexion is a certain way.
Again, that's the same man that needs to check himself. Okay, what you're looking for superficial things.
Right.
That's all. How she looks, how this, what else?
But you know what?
What else? You want that Instagram girl?
Who doesn't want a beautiful
person? So you want the trouble that comes along with it?
At the end of the day, beauty's in the eye of the beholder. Who doesn't want a beautiful person?
Very true.
So you can't, like, knock him for wanting somebody, like, cute.
And men are visual.
Right.
Men are visual. The bottom line is men are visual. I get that. Men are visual. But this is the thing. You can't solely be visual.
Right.
You can't solely be visual. You can't only want a woman because she has a big butt and perfect skin.
Right.
Right.
You have to want somebody who also has a good heart.
Right.
And I'm going to be real with you. A lot of pretty women don't have to have a good heart because they're pretty.
Right. In whose books? Well,
what about the girls that just want the D?
I never met any of those. Next question, please. No, it's funny. I spoke about this today. I've yet to meet a female who I can just have sex with. It's always and I don't know if it's me, I don't know if it's the women I'm choosing, but they always want some kind of,
it's the women you're choosing.
Over a consistent, like,
it's
I've yet,
you're choosing.
It has to be, because
I
don't know.
Let me be real with you, and I love you, you know I love you.
Right.
It's the women you're choosing, because to be honest with you, just like only a certain kind of man can be with me,
right,
only a certain kind of man can capture my attention, I can only capture a certain type of man's attention.
Right.
Only a certain kind of woman is going to want to be with you.
Right.
Only a certain kind of woman is really going to capture your attention.
Right.
And so it is the women that you're choosing.
Right.
It really is.
Well, I mean, to be, well, I guess I don't want a woman who's able to just have sex. I do, but
you, no.
But,
so really, you need to put out what you really do want from them.
No. Once I do that, like I said, women aren't respect. I guess good women aren't receptive to that.
I think they want more. When you hold a certain amount of qualities, I mean,
yeah, I think they fall in love with a real
man or a woman cannot
deny it.
Right. I mean, you cannot say I only want the D because. This person has like so many more qualities that I find attractive.
Right.
So I want more. Right.
But when you really think about it, uh-huh. to be honest, and just talking about you,
okay.
There are different kinds of women for you.
Right.
There's a certain kind of woman that you'll have sex with one time and then you'll never talk to again.
True.
And then there's another kind of woman that you'll have sex with more than once and you'll communicate with and you'll have an interaction with, you have a relationship with. Mm. And generally, those are the women who want to have more from you.
Right. Well, the ones that I have sex with once, they still be like, and I have to hit them with the Heisman. So
you got it like that.
And the funny part about it is it has nothing to do with physical at all. That's why I believe with Siobhan, I believe my shit is strong. My mental is strong with that,
nice.
and probably just what I represent as a man.
That's
I don't think it's physical, even though that's icing
on
the cake.
But I think the ones that would really, I mean, like you as a person, is like if anyone takes any bit of time of being a Facebook friend or learning how you talk and you know the different things that you say, the woman that just wants the D is gonna be intimidated to actually even be like, hey, I want the D.
Yeah,
because that would be the one off with her head, like.
Well, makes sense.
Yeah, because you are different.
Makes sense. Mm, but since we have you, and I want to tell you guys, I praise and respect your intellect. But we go, of course, because we got the ladies here. We also want to give the men the gift of the physical. So we want to go into the dominance in the bedroom or the submission in the bedroom. Mm. We have a caller. We're gonna go to the caller, and then we're gonna get to that. Caller, you have reached the He Say, She Say Show. Are you there?
I'm here.
Hey.
Hi.
Hi.
Have you been listening?
I have not been listening.
Oh.
But my answer to your question is no.
Which one?
A man does not complete a...
You don't think that a man complete? Well, I'm gonna let the women who agree that they do kind of answer.
Well, my question to you is, why is that your response?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, because these days women are too independent, and men they just don't have too much to offer us women these days. It's not the same.
And you know what? I completely agree. And that's what I was saying. It's like what the man brings to the table. If you don't bring anything to the table but penis.
It's like, what's the point? How are you going to complete me if you can't take care of me?
Right.
Oh, so do you feel that a man has to take care of you in order
not
to...
Not even take care of me, like be even on my same level or...
So you don't
know,
think that, again, and going with that.
Then you
don't
be think, looking for
you don't,
completion
hold
in
on,
that man.
Hold on. You don't think that there's any men in this world on your level?
I mean, it is, but at the same time, I haven't met that man or that match. If that was the case, I wouldn't be single.
So ultimately, let me ask you this. If a man came to the table with certain things, do you think that it would be possible or do you think that he would be able to complete you?
No, it's because he wants you to accept a lot of the BS that comes.
Who are you talking about?
Well,
why did that man have to come with BS? Look, homie from the hood. We ain't talking.
Take care of you.
We ain't talking about the homie from the hood.
He is going to want you to tolerate a lot of his shit.
We ain't talking about the blood homie from the hood. We're talking about a real solid man who, whatever your, let's hypothetically put this good man in your life. Because everything you came back with have been a negative, and that makes me question, who are you dating? Who are you fucking with? So have you ever had a guy who was of substance that tickled your fancy?
Mm. What do you mean by tickle my fancy? Like
that was standard. That was good standards for you.
Yes, but at the same time, it was like he wanted to change something about me, or you know, it was.
Was it a positive change? Did he want you to sell dope? Was the change?
But don't try to think I'm going to change overnight because I'm not going to change overnight just because you want me to.
I've been in situations like that too. and I offered her
because you don't eat pork don't mean I'm finna stop eating my ribs.
You better convert. I love bacon. I'm gonna eat my bacon.
So, for me, I'm gonna say no.
So let me ask you this: what do you do? You feel like there's anything that you need a man for?
These days, not really.
You don't need that D.
I can go to the store and get some AAA batteries and pop that in, but that's a big deal though.
But that's the thing. If you don't feel like you, and I'm not talking to you, I'm just speaking generally. If you don't feel like you need a man for then you're not going to feel like
you're
a man.
Then that makes sense.
Right. And that completely makes sense.
But I think if that has a lot to do with the past of the person. I mean, like, I feel like that's like somewhat bringing the baggage. Correct. Everything you've dealt with from the past experiences and the men that you've dealt with in your life. Mm-hmm. Because there's no way you can say that you feel complete as a person.
A lot of, you know, it's...
But why couldn't I be complete by myself? Why would a man complete me? Because there's no balance. Like, a man is not going to complete me.
You actually wasn't born by yourself. That's the funny part about it. It's a cycle. You were born from a man and a woman. So,
I mean, that's true, but I mean, it doesn't take a man to complete a woman.
Okay. Well, thanks for your call. I appreciate you. I hope everything works out.
Thank you for calling.
No problem.
What's your name? Because she sounds like super like.
Yeah, she's gonna have 50 cats in the
lady
with the shoes.
Wait. What's your name? Or just throw me any name. It don't even have to be your name. Just throw me any name.
Monica.
Okay, Monica. I want you to. I'm gonna give you some homework.
Come on, give me some. Here, I got my pen. I'm ready.
She got her pen. She ready. She taking notes.
I want you to call. First of all, I want you to call back to another show. But in the meantime, I want you to think about what in your life could be better that you can't do for yourself, or what about you could be better that you can't do for yourself. And I'm gonna give you an example from me. I'm gonna be transparent right now. I am very selfish. I don't have any children. I work for myself. I live alone. I don't have anybody that I have to do for. I don't have anybody that I have to give to. So for me, a man gives me a level of balance because it takes away some of my selfishness. Mm-hmm. Do I need him to provide a place to live? No. A car? No, I got that. Do I need it for food? No, I got that too. I got clothes. I have all of that. But when I really get down to the core of me, without someone to give to, I can be very, very selfish because I don't have anybody to think about.
Right. The balance.
But me. So for me, a man takes away some of that selfishness and he makes me think about someone other than myself. And to be the best person I can be,
right.
I can't be selfish. Like, selfishness is not in the plan to be the best person I can be.
But see, we're the total opposite because I'm far from selfish. I will give you my laugh. I'll give you the shirt off my back and walk in my bra. And it's like I have two kids and, you know, it's like
That's my thing, though. But I want you to figure out what your thing is.
Like you say, I don't want for nothing. My kids don't want for nothing.
I don't know, you just really need the person to merge in your life, not really take over your life, but just kind of go with you and guide you. We want to eat out every day, seven days a week we can. Well, can you take me to get some crab? I really have to deep inside me to find that. Monica, I need you to take me to get some crab because I'm hungry.
Okay, you want to go to Barlin Crab?
Yes, girl. Yes.
We can go Sunday.
Yes.
No, seriously.
Well, Monica, thanks for calling. Have a good evening.
Okay, you do the same.
Thank you. Good night.
Seriously, I think she would have been like better off with like someone older who's probably like a lot of like independently strong women probably need that older person who's already been there, done that, experienced life. They're kind of like retired and they can actually push and motivate.
But I hear that. But from what I see, she just don't want to listen. With that being said, we run out of time. We run out of time. But I can't forget the men's treat. So I want to ask you guys this.
Yes.
I'm gonna ask you guys in the bedroom sexually, are you submissive or dominant? And what's one of the quote unquote, put the camera on me, freakiest things that you've done in the bedroom?
Oh, no.
Dominant or submissive? Because we run out of time, so this is our last.
I like to be submissive in the bedroom. The only area I'm dominant in is when I'm performing oral sex. When I'm performing oral sex, I'm gonna need you to just let me be who I'm gonna be, and let me be dominant. Other than when I'm doing that,
right?
Then I want you to dominate me.
Thanks for that answer. Beautiful sound.
Snaps look like we're in a theater.
Siobhan.
I would totally agree.
No, I don't need to agree.
I need to, for me personally.
Right.
In the bedroom, submissive, 100%. But yes, in that area.
What's the area?
Don't tell me that. Oral. Please don't tell me that.
You can tell me what to do.
Y'all give
me. But this is the thing. I think sometimes because a lot of people don't do it right, or they don't really get into it.
Right.
You guys are really, sometimes see if she's going to do it right first.
Wait a minute. Right. Famous quote. You blocking your blessing.
You blocking your blessings, baby.
Right. Don't block your blessing.
So, you need, you can articulate that.
Right.
You can articulate what you need. But see if you need to articulate what you need first.
Right.
Absolutely.
April. Dominant or submissive, and what's one of the, I guess, freakiest things you've did for or in the bedroom?
Well, to be honest with you, I personally like to be both. I'm both.
Okay.
I'm dominant in the parts where I want to show you where I'm, like, doing. You know what I'm saying? I want to take you there. Submissive to where you're definitely taking me there. And whatever it is, like, I'm totally, like, open for it. But, and then as far as, like, freaky things, I'm kind of, like, I don't know. I would like to say kind of kinky and open-minded, because sex is, like, really free-spirited. It's inhibitions. It's a connection between two people. Not really mechanical, but whatever it is that you guys are, like, merging. That's what I mean when I say a guy merging into my lane, because it's right. Not you really directing me. I'm directing you. We just kind of going at it together.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? On the ocean. So with that being said, it kind of goes from the moon to the ground. You know what I'm saying? I have got, I've gotten milk poured upon me in the motions of the ocean.
The hot milk.
Interesting. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? I role play, right. It is what it, like, and I'm definitely a pleaser. So it's like, to be honest with you, I don't know what your height is as far as, like, what's the kinkiest, but I think I'm sexually free and free spirited. So
love it.
I'm not limited.
Okay. Love it.
Well, I want to thank you guys for coming. Love your answers. Love your energy, and I appreciate you. This was the Lioness Den.
For sure.
Right.
Thank you, ladies, so much.
Thank you for coming. Thank the listeners. Thank the viewers. You can reach us every Tuesday at 8 p.m. at He Say, She Say. It'll be me and the beautiful Shawn Jones next week.
Can I say something?
Oh, go ahead.
I'm sorry. If any Wild Black Cherries tuned in, I do thank you. Go ahead.
Thank you guys for
listening. I'll explain to Wild Black Cherries to you.
Thanks. Wait, Wild Black Cherries? Ooh, I'm interested. You guys have a good night, and thank you.
Good night.
Good night.
In my life, I've seen it all, and now it's time for me to pass on this knowledge to you, all my sisters, my troubled sisters. This is my gift to you. Been many days, couldn't take the pain that I should take my life away. Seen every day in every other young sister's face. To sit back and see the same thing that happened to me happen to you.